Hello and welcome. My name is Erica Caruter and I'm an educational consultant at Patton Harrisburg. In this short video, we will learn about an easy strategy to help children learn math vocabulary terms at home. If you visit the Patton YouTube channel and check out the math playlist, you'll find another video there called The Importance of Math Vocabulary and Some Helpful Resources, where we explored this concept of math vocabulary and a few online resources you can access from home to support your students. Check it out. Okay, so let's take a minute and think about why is math vocabulary important? Well, students are asked to verbalize their thinking about problem solving, read word problems, complete journal entries, write responses, and explain processes of their problem solving. Students really need to be fluent and accurate in their use of mathematical vocabulary to understand, hear, read, think, and write mathematically. Math is really its own language. It's also important we learn vocabulary for math symbols. Math is a language that includes symbols to represent different words and actions. It's a very precise language. So what might be an easy way that we could do at home to help teach some of those math vocabulary terms? We're going to learn today about the Frayer model. So what is a Frayer model? It really is just a graphic organizer or a tool that can be used when teaching children new math vocabulary words. It can help children and teens build mathematical vocabulary skills, as well as enhance their knowledge of math concepts. So you could use a Frayer model at home when your child is learning a new term, especially for terms that are important for current and future learning, and can also be connected to some other concepts. It's important to consider if that term has some examples and non-examples, and we'll explore that a little bit further here. So a Frayer model really is used to help teach mathematical vocabulary terms. It's not a worksheet. So initial instruction about the Frayer model is really heavily adult directed, and it requires adults and teachers to model that. So we would want to show students how to complete this graphic organizer by talking through what we're doing and how we come up with information that would be entered into the different sections. We also want to help students learn how to use textbook and other subject materials to generate and discuss some information in each of the sections. So first we pick our word or our term that's important to be learned, that we can connect to some other concepts, and then that has some examples and non-examples. We'd want to help the youth talk through what's the definition in your own words. Then we'd want to help the youth find some additional features that would help them recognize and identify that word. So that's where our textbooks or other resources may come in handy. We'd want to have some examples, so synonyms or other words or terms that mean the same thing. This is also a great place to draw some concrete examples or even some pictures of that concept. And finally, we want to have some non-examples, so maybe some relevant pictures that are similar but do not quite fit the characteristics. Maybe some things that are opposite or antonyms, or things that students might get confused. This helps them think through that process. And let's look at an example here. So here's an example of a completed Frayer model. Now, when we sit down with a student, we wouldn't give them a completed Frayer model. Again, talking through that's very important. So here's an example with the term quadrilateral. We would start with the term in the middle of the Frayer model, and we would ask the student, you know, tell me what is a quadrilateral? Tell me in your own words. So the student might say something like, it's a shape with four sides that are straight. Great. Now let's dive a little bit deeper into that. Let's get out our text, or let's look at some other resources. So we find some additional facts and characteristics about quadrilaterals. So it's a polygon with four sides and four angles. All the interior angles add up to 360 degrees. The word quadrilateral comes from quad, meaning four, and lateral meaning of sides. Then we have a few examples. So we see in here, we have a square, we have a rhombus, we have a rectangle. Those all meet the definition as well as the facts and characteristics. Now notice in our non-examples, we have some additional shapes, but when we look at those facts and characteristics, they don't quite match up. So a triangle only has three sides and three angles. We look at a hexagon that has five sides, etc. So this is a great place to kind of talk through that with the student. We don't want anything in our non-examples that are way out in left field, like drawing a watermelon or a unicorn. We want to keep it to things that don't quite meet the facts and characteristics. So maybe you're wondering, well, you know, how might I build some Frayer models at home? It's pretty easy to do. All you need is a sheet of blank paper. And this is a small arts and crafts project you can do with your kids right at home. So we start with our sheet of blank paper. The first thing we do is we fold it in half lengthwise. Then we fold it again widthwise. So now the paper is about 1/4 the size of when we started. The next thing that we'll do, you'll see we'll take the edge of the fold where all the corners meet and fold it down into a small triangle. So when you open your paper, it looks like this. There's an area in the center for you to write the vocabulary term, as well as the four surrounding areas where you can identify what's the definition in the child's own terms, what are some facts and characteristics, what are some examples and non-examples. You can draw around the lines if that makes it easier, but it literally takes like 30 seconds to make one. Thank you for visiting today. Please check out our website at www.patton.net and check out the Mathematics Initiative for additional resources.